Hey gang, it's W from Need a Cat Media. Thanks for coming back to the channel. Today I got a great video for you based on a bunch of requests from the comments that everyone's been leaving. The comments are wonderful, so thank you. This video is on creating and managing accounts in Plex. So if you have multiple people who live in your house, if you have children of younger age or teens or what have you, Plex does give you the ability to create individual accounts, each for them, to give restrictions on the content they can watch. And today, I'm going to show you how to do that. Let's get started. So this is a really simple process. Let's get into Plex. So the first thing that we want to do is come over here to the little wrench. This is your settings. And if you click on this over here on your left hand side over here, we're just going to scroll down till we get to the Plex Home. And we're going to give that a click. And in here, and I want to make this a little bit bigger. In here, you can see that I have four accounts that are created. When you first come in here, you're only going to see your first one. And that's going to be your administrator, which in this case is me. And you can see that I have created a PIN to prevent anyone from the house when they come in to changing any of the settings that are in here. And you can simply do that by putting in a requirement. As you can see, there's little locks here. You just click on one and then you can set your PIN. Or if you want to change the PIN, you can click on edit and go ahead and do that. The last part here is the same where you click on the X and it deletes the account. Under this, I have already created three other accounts. I have two sons. One is an adult, so I created him a separate one which has no restrictions. And then down here I have my other son, and he's in his early teens. I put some restrictions on his, so let's go ahead and take a look at this. You can see I have it set for teen. So you're going to want to click on this, and then it's going to open up to this screen. To begin, you have four sections here. You have libraries, you have media, you have your profile, and then you have your restrictions. For this demo, we'll go through each of these, but you're really only going to be paying attention to the libraries and then the restrictions. So in the library section, when you click on this, which is what we're in right now, you can see that I have movies and TVs selected. We could click on edit and scroll down, and you can see all the different libraries that we have created. And you can simply just put a checkbox to what you want and then go ahead and hit save. Under the media section, really isn't anything for you to do there, so you don't have to worry about that. Under profiles, this is simply where you're building your profile, and you can add a photo here, the face of your child. My kid likes Spider-Man, so there's your Spider-Man icon. And then on the last section, you have restrictions, and this is where you're going to determine exactly what content on your library that each account is able to watch. So from here, we're going to click on edit. And within the edit screen, there's four sections you can pull down. You have younger kids, older kids, teen, and none. And under here is a description where it says your younger kid allows, that's your youth, your G movies and equivalent, your older kids, this is up to you to determine, is where you're going to be giving them PG or PG equivalent content. And then you have your teens, and that's going to be your TV-14, your PG-13, and anything that, again, that you feel is appropriate for your child. Outside of that, with a Plex Pass, you can choose your own ratings and manage other media server permissions. We're going to bypass that. I don't have a Plex Pass. It's pretty cool that you're able to come in here and determine what they can watch. We have Plex compatible televisions. The app is installed on pretty much all of our televisions, and my son has it obviously in his room, so he can watch his Spider-Man movies or whatever else he'd like to watch. But these are the restrictions that we put on here. Below that, you can disallow download movies. If your child is going to access Plex through the computer, you can disable downloads. And then I also have downloading live TV. We have a TV provider or a content provider, so there really isn't any reason. If you're interested in this, I do have another video that was recently posted that talks about live TV and all the content. It is pretty cool. You should check it out. There'll be a link at the end of the video that'll take you right to it. So we're going to go back to the main Plex home screen and we'll scroll down. So other questions are, why do you have a family? Well, I have a family account here, which has no restrictions, so that as we're watching and having TV night, I don't have to log in with a PIN, and we can just have the full content and not have to worry about what's going on in our living room, game room. If you like this video and you found it helpful, and I think you will, please consider subscribing to the channel. Give us a like, hit the bell for notifications. That way, when we upload new content, you'll be the first to know, and you can check that out. We would greatly appreciate that. And if you have any questions about this, please put them in the comment, and I'll be happy to answer them for you. We have a lot more videos for you, so stick around.